Pope Francis makes an appeal against religious extremism as he kicked off his trip to the world's largest Muslim country. The Holy Father met Wednesday with Indonesia's political leaders at the presidential palace in Jakarta. Francis vowed improved interfaith dialogue to help tamp down religious violence.
There are times when faith in God is continually placed in the forefront, but is sadly manipulated to foment divisions and increase hatred, instead of furthering peace, communion, dialogue, respect, cooperation, and fraternity. Dear brothers and sisters, in the face of the above challenges, it is encouraging that the philosophy guiding the organization of the Indonesian state is both balanced and wise.
Earlier today, the Pope met with the underprivileged in Jakarta. The gathering included Rohingya refugees, orphan children, and homeless persons. Francis is embarking on the longest trip yet of his 11-year papacy.
The long arm of the law catches up with fugitive dismissed Mayor Alice Guo, also known as Chinese national Guo Huaping. She was arrested by Indonesian authorities in Tangerang City, confirming earlier reports she was hiding in Indonesia. Guo is expected to return to the Philippines on Thursday or Friday.
We are in close coordination with the Indonesian counterpart. Ibibigay naman sa atin agad. Pwedeng bukas, makalawa, maibalik na namin dito si Alice. Idediretso muna sa BI, Bureau of Immigration, for immigration na violations. And then, itaturn over sa amin. Kami naman ipoprocess namin. And kung anong criminal charges ang maisampan namin sa kanya. But remember na we have already filed several charges against her. Hindi pa lang umaabot sa hukuman, nasa fiscal level pa lang. Like the other day, we have filed the anti-money laundering cases against Guo and others.
Justice Secretary Crispin Rimulya vowing to make Guo accountable for crimes she committed. He adds state agencies are still discussing who will take custody of the dismissed mayor when she is brought back to the country.
Usapan yan, alam mo, hindi naman kami magkalaban ng PNP, magkakampi kami. Diba? So, it should not be an issue. Sigurado, bibiyaya siya ng Senate kasi meron pa siyang kailangan harapin sa Senado. Hindi pa siya tapos doon. At ganun din ang House. Ang may investigasyon na ginagawa yung Quadcom, hindi lang namin alam pa kung sino ang maghahawak sa kanya.
Guo fled the Philippines illegally back in July as the Senate issued an arrest order for her for snubbing its inquiry into illegal offshore gaming operations in her town. Her cohorts, Sheila Guo and Cassandra Lee Ong, were also apprehended in Indonesia last month. Alice Guo was dismissed as mayor of Bambantarlak amid allegations linking her to illegal pogo activities. She's also accused of using a fake identity to gain Filipino citizenship, which allowed her to run for mayor of Bamban.
Philippine senators thanking Indonesian authorities for arresting dismissed Mayor Alice Guo. In a statement, Senate President Francis Escudero says Guo can now be brought to justice and hopefully shed light on illegal offshore gaming operations in the country. He likewise congratulates Philippine and Indonesian law enforcement authorities. The senator, leading the probe into Guo's alleged pogo ties, Senator Riz Ontiveros says she looks forward to having Guo face the Congress once more. Ontiveros had pushed for the Senate arrest order against Guo.
I am fully expecting magsasalita na siya ng kumpleto at makatotohanan. Kasi patunay itong pag-aresto sa kanya na hindi siya makakatakas talaga. Tumakas man siya nung una, nahuli pa rin siya at ibabalik dito. Kumbaga, she has nowhere else to go. At yung mga tumulong sa kanyang makatakas, hindi namin sila tatantanan.
The Senate Sergeant at Arms assures the public Guo will be safe once she is detained in the Senate. She is expected to be turned over to the upper house after she undergoes processing at the Immigration Bureau and the National Bureau of Investigation. But Senator Sherwin Gatchalian warns Guo may be transferred to regular detention if she refuses to cooperate with the Senate's investigation.
Wala na siyang choice eh, no? Dead end na ito para sa kanya. Ito na yung dead end, no? Makita natin ang daming kasong hinaharap niya after the Senate. Kung ma-extract namin yung mga information sa kanya at hindi pa na-file yung mga kaso at wala pang hold departure order, eh baka pwede siyang tumakas ulit. Flight risk na siya at this point eh. So importante na may hold departure order even after the Senate hearings.